last up, someone else who's sick tonight, because she had children. Allison Ward Barber from the United Way is going to come tell us about, what's the title? Ending Poverty Through Virtual Reality.
Yes. So on your closer, are they trying to get Beyonce? Sorry. A poor alternative. But let's start with a story. So imagine that you're driving down Capitol Boulevard and your radio's playing really loudly and you find yourself at a stoplight. Kind of looking out the window and you see this mother and her young children walking hand in hand across a parking lot towards the front doors of a motel. And so your mind kind of shoots to growing up when you used to take road trips with your own family. And you used to fight over which side of the bed you were going to sleep on and which sibling you had to sleep by and who was going to get to the pool the fastest, right? So your mind kind of drifts from this mother and her young children. But as they walk into that motel, their conversation reflects the conversation that you probably had a million times with your parents when they picked you up from school and took you home. Something like, I'm hungry. Or, did you bring your homework home? Or, she's poking me. Or, I love you too. At night, this mother, Peggy, and her children, her four children, take pillows and blankets down from a shelf and start laying them on the floor because they're in one room of a hotel and they're making their beds for the evening on torn carpet where a radiator is leaking water. They have bed bugs as well, and Peggy makes sure that every morning she inspects her children carefully and picks off those black bugs from their skin before they head out to go to school. She tells her children to roll over when it becomes nighttime so that the nightly news won't wake them up and they need to get enough sleep for school in the morning, because she's sharing a bed with these two young children, the only bed in the room. And the only privacy she's given herself is tacking up a curtain in between. This is a story for too many children here in the Triangle. 800 children will go to bed tonight in a motel. Now imagine that you're Peggy. Imagine this is you holding up your child, knowing that this evening that child will be sleeping next to you in a queen bed in a motel, along with your other five children that evening. Imagine that you're working as hard as you can when you're not watching your children. You're picking up odd jobs like sewing and doing other people's laundry. And you're making just enough to keep you in the hotel. And if there's anything left over, you're purchasing shoes and clothes for the kids to go to school. Imagine if you were Peggy. Because I'm last, we're going to do a little interaction. How does that make you feel? Someone yell something out. Right? Anything?
Yes.
What are you feeling?
Anxious.
Anxious. Stressed.
Overwhelmed.
Absolutely overwhelmed. So we believe that there is power in empathy. We know that there's a correlation between power and action. And your United Way also believes that there's power in leveraging empathy into action, so that Peggy can realize her dream of providing for her children a future that she didn't have access to. Your United Way is working really differently here in the Triangle by supporting 24 collaborative partnerships, which are groups of agencies that are placing Peggy and her children at the center of service delivery, where they go and they get to meet all of the agencies at one time instead of bouncing from agency to agency. And that's powerful. And the way that we're currently trying to tell that story, and the way that we are eliciting empathy, is through our MVP, if you will, our poverty simulations. Perhaps some of you have participated in poverty simulations. But that's a limited scope for the 30 people that show up and are able for just a few hours to understand what it's like to be Peggy and her children. So we're really looking for a group of people to pair technology with these poverty simulations so that we can scale empathy. Could you imagine if we could scale empathy? But we have the power in this room to do so. So I'm making a shameless pitch now that I'll probably make tomorrow as well, to gain your help in developing a virtual reality poverty simulator. Something that you could have on a phone, and for at least temporarily 15 minutes, understand what it's truly like to be in the city of Raleigh and trying to get your basic needs met, like Peggy and her children. Because we believe that there's power in getting people to empathize. And if we can get that widespread power across the city of Raleigh, think about how powerful that could be for not only Peggy and her children, but the other 800 children that are going to be going to sleep tonight in motels. Thank you.